You're listening to The Olive Tree with me, Julia Fisher, the programme that brings you a fresh glimpse of life in Israel and the West Bank, that of believers in Jesus who live there, Jewish and Arab and Palestinian people, to hear what God is doing in the region despite the conflicts that frequently erupt. My guest today is Evan Thomas, pastor of a Messianic congregation in Netanya. He's also a leading figure in the work of reconciliation between Jews and Palestinians, as this week's programme will reveal. He and his wife Marla recently led a team of 12 Israeli believers, 6 were Jewish and 6 were Palestinian, to Germany, where they joined with a group of young German Christians. The idea was to work together and present their combined stories to the people they would meet. I asked Evan whose idea this was.
The idea was actually a mixture of a very dear German colleague, Susanna, and myself. And we had been really wrestling for some time of where we were going with the whole reconciliation issue. Now, for Susanna, it was more the German-Jewish issue of this continual returning to ask forgiveness for the Holocaust and so forth, and going over and over and over and over again without it really going beyond that. And I was wrestling with the whole Israeli-Palestinian conflict in the same way, you know, beyond that, what is there? So we got our heads together and both of us came up with what the Lord had downloaded for us, and that was mission. And so now what we do is bring, particularly working with young adults who really are our change makers for the future, and we're giving them the opportunity to experience mission in the diverse mission field of Central Europe at the moment, and bringing these young people together, forming fabulous relationships, and just going out and sharing the message of the gospel with whoever we encounter. And the whoever we encounter, of course, is myriads of Muslim refugees and asylum seekers, local Germans, of course, and tons of Israelis that are pouring through Germany and many settling and working in central, you know, major cities.
You called yourself "We Are the Message." Mm-hmm. So I mean, so many dynamics here, because you've got this group from Israel, Arabs mm-hmm. and Jews for starters, who possibly didn't even know each other before they went.
I mean, definitely did not know each other. They didn't know each other before we brought them together.
So you had to weld the team together on the hoof, as it were.
Exactly. So Marla and I love hosting, so, and we love this age group, the young people, and they willingly come to us, starting off with good food together and fellowship, and the Lord does the rest. I saw, for example, in one evening, months before we set out, just bringing the young people together, they were the best of friends within minutes.
How does that happen? Because there's so much that can divide them.
I think part of it is what we saw in the early days of reconciliation work. There is an initial excitement of discovering brothers and sisters from the sector or the other whom you don't have interaction with because of the conflict, and then all the cultural restraints of language, etc., etc. But these young people, you know, they love the thing that they have in common, of course, is common faith. They may have some very big theological and political differences and life experience, living even within the same small land. But the excitement of what we call the Hummus and Hallelujah stage. They get together, and then we don't run away from the conflict issues. And Marla and I have skill sets that cover 30-odd years of looking closely at the narrative, facilitating work of, you know, conflicted communities, particularly young adults. And so we take those things and we pass them, as it were, through the grid of the ethics of the kingdom of God, of what Yeshua taught, and it instantly makes sense for them. They're able to put aside their political or theological differences and say, let's go with the message to the world. And as they do that, they discover that they have so much more in common. And so there's the opportunity to allow the word, the Lord to work within, for example, the context of the historical conflict between Germans and Jews. And here we are several generations down the road. And that's very helpful to young Germans and a bit of an eye-opener for our young Jewish believers. But the Palestinian-Israeli conflict is ongoing. It's not just historic. It's with us all the time. And that is enormously challenging. But you do it in a so the challenge it manifests itself or expresses itself, should I say, in the framework where you're out sharing the most important message to your life with other people that don't know the Lord.
There's a story you told about the day that you went to a football match.
Yeah, that was again, when you see the hand of the Lord work in an extraordinary way beyond what you plan. So we took the whole team. We were invited to come and join a football club that brings young refugees, Muslim refugees, together from a wide variety of backgrounds, Syrians and Afghanis and Iraqis and you name it. And they play football and their families come together with them. And so this was in southern Bavaria. So we were told, but you know, could we please not missionize them because it's kind of sensitive? We said, yeah, well, come play football. And so we had a great game. And then after a couple of months of severe drought in Germany, the heavens opened up and it started to pour with rain, literally driving us all into the football stadium. And we'd brought a mobile sound system with us because we'd do some dancing and games with the children of the refugees and these sorts of things. And we brought that, of course, into the stadium. And then some of the Syrians said to us, tell us about your group. So one of the sisters from the Galilee, Arab sister, said, I will. And she is a real evangelist. And so in Arabic, with German translation going on to the side, she shared the heart of the gospel with these group of Muslims, some of them Orthodox Muslims. And she finished and they all applauded, and because she's addressing them in Arabic and she's doing it in a very loving way. And they said, yeah, but we want to hear from our Jewish neighbor as well. You know, for a lot of them, they'd never met an Israeli or Jews before. They were, you know, the devil incarnate for numbers of these young Syrians. So everybody turned and looked at me. I said, okay. So, and I gave just a spontaneous 10-minute message on the love of the Messiah, and then asked their permission if I could pray for them all and their families in the name that is above all names of Yeshua, Jesus, the Messiah. They, yes, yes. And then I prayed over them, blessed them, and again, just applauded. And there was this loving atmosphere. Now, none of this was choreographed. It was a totally spontaneous thing that occurred. And the message of the gospel impacted probably 50, 60 Muslim asylum seekers right there in that stadium.
You say you left that place, your hearts were just thrilled. You weren't expecting it.
Not at all. And so when we would cross over and spend afternoons over in Salzburg along the riverbank there, where just hundreds of thousands of visitors from all over the world were assembling for a big music festival, we'd take our teams, and the teams would be always a mixture of Israeli, Hebrew speakers, Palestinian Christians, and German Christians. And we developed this theme of, you know, we are the message. We would ask people, do you believe in miracles? Of course, most would say, well, not really. I said, well, would you like to see one? And they said, sure. And it's the esoteric world we live in. I said, well, we are a miracle. And then we would explain what brought us together, who we are, and our backgrounds. And people were absolutely amazed, and gave us opportunities time after time where we would be standing praying with people. There was one case where my Palestinian colleague, Elias from Nazareth, and I stood hand in hand with an extended family from Kuwait, Orthodox Muslims from Kuwait, standing there, all of us with eyes closed, praying in the name of Jesus, blessing their family, asking God to bring revelation into their lives. And, you know, just no one rejected us. It was amazing.
You've been listening to Evan Thomas, a Messianic Jewish pastor from Israel. The Olive Tree Reconciliation Fund is a Christian charity based in the UK that supports the needs of both Jewish believers and Arab or Palestinian Christians living in Israel and the wider Middle East. If you'd like to know more about our work through our bi-monthly newsletter, including news about our upcoming tours, please either visit our website www.olivetreefund.org or write to me, Julia Fisher, OT RF, PO Box 402, Billingshurst, RH 14, 4BQ in the UK. Meanwhile, join me at the same time next week for another story from the Olive Tree. Until then, goodbye.